One of the most distinctive English bands to emerge at the turn of the 70s was Audience, a sui generis act who incorporated banjo and woodwinds into their unique, unclassifiable sound. And from their second album, Friends, 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 the track Priestess. Friends, Friends, Friend. It's a bit of a tongue twister. Howard Werth has a very distinctive voice that I can't compare to very many people. It's kind of it's got a certain tone. I once heard the description reedy used. Well, to describe the voice of John Watts of Fingerprints, and I'm not saying the two of them sound alike, but they've both got a certain tone that most people that almost seems to be like a disguise of a real voice, like like high on her throne. Like, is that really his voice, or is it like just a voice that he puts on? Let's catch up with the lyrics here. Believe it or not, they're actually printed. Bathed in moonlight, devil worshippers chanting. Throughout the night, music grew ever haunting. High on her throne, Satan seated beside her. Face cold as stone, prince of darkness to guide her. Huh. Priestess, priestess, merciless, merciless, murderess, murderess. Priestess, 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 merciless, merciless, murderess, murderess. I get the feeling like his voice might just be kind of a trademark affectation, in the way that Russell Mayall's voices, Russell Mayall's speaking voice doesn't sound the way that he sings at all, or that Peter Hamill is like those are just kind of like trademark voices that these singers adopt. I love the brimming open cadences and just the brisk strumming that's going on and the urgency of it all. Bit of some loose jamming here in E minor. That's the flute work of the ubiquitous Keith Gemmell, who would later turn up in Stackeridge. Let's see, there was another verse I didn't read. poor helpless child brought unto devil's daughter. Crowd's eyes went wild, eager to see the torture. Oh, so we're in like, oh, we're in ancient times, like oh, ancient Rome, perhaps, you know, we're dealing with like a Craven-esque society here. Laid at her feet, stretched across marble altar. Ritual complete, drew her sword for the slaughter. It's almost like Sign of the Cross or something. Back when crowds of people would gather to watch others get tortured or something. I wonder what part of the plot this passage is supposed to, like, characterize, add musical accompaniment to. I mean, are we in a moment of suspense? I'm picturing like gallows or something, and like the stench, like the flute may represent some aroma that's, you know. Or I'm picturing birds landing on the the barred window to the torture chamber. Let's see, basically what we're hearing right now, we're hearing Howard Werth and we're hearing Keith Gemmell as percussionist, pianist Tony Connor kind of sits things out. And I guess we're hearing a little bit of sustained kind of low end from bassist Trevor Williams, just ever so slightly. I guess they've taken like a note of his and like stretched it out. We're hearing like the sustain of it. Or they're fading it in and out. Yeah, where else could that be coming from? It's not coming from a keyboard. I guess the comparisons to Moonchild are a little bit obvious here. And Moonchild does kind of tax a lot of listeners' patience. I like this jam right here, and now while we've only got a minute and 20 seconds left to go, I kind of wish that this portion had taken up a bit more of the middle section than what we were hearing a minute back. listen to Keith Gemmell rip it up on that sax. Slightly higher. It's a different he doesn't really follow any exact like vocal melody. He just kind of lets the lyrics pour out over the chords, but he's doing them a bit higher, like I don't know, like key in thirds or fifths or something, like, because the key center hasn't changed. He's just singing it higher. Was quite a snare roll at the end there. That was Audience with the track Priestess from the album Friends, Friends, Friend. And I am wondering, just I'm trying to track the possession of that phrase. It's like a friend, we all know what a friend's friend is, a friend of a friend, a friend's friends. Throwing two plural possessive friends before the word friend, it's kind of throwing me somewhat. The rest of the lyrics. The night was plagued by storms. People came in swarms, trying to keep warm, all to the house of the overlord. Through the night they came for food and game, the poor, weak, the lame, all to the house of the overlord. All through the year they would work and they'd sweat and wait for the time of the year, wait for the time when the man from the mansion would open his house and appear, wealthy and regal, inviting the people to sit at the table and dine, drinking their health he would serve them himself with his music, his food, and his wine. Basically, living in an era, you know, living in, could be like medieval times, you know, when you had despotic rulers and you had people just clamoring for cookie crumbs. On the other hand, you could also say that this could serve as a metaphor for people, groups of people placing their trust in a guy who, you know, gets on the soapbox or gets on the pulpit. And you could say that it could be a metaphor for the dangers of groupthink. And considering some of the things, and this came out in 1970, considering some of the religious cult movements that caught on in the 1970s, it's like a lesson that needs to be taught over and over and over again. Once again, ever since I went down that Jonestown rabbit hole a few months ago and started just consuming copious amounts of Jim Jones YouTube content, and there, you know, like I see analogies in, I don't know, about a fourth of the lyrics that I read these days. Anyway, for more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Audience, the four albums they put out, see the directory of albums by English A artists linked in the description below, and follow me on social media to know when the next video is coming out, and comment about what you liked about this video, any points that you agreed with, points that you disagreed with. And until next time, This is Zaragon, the world's most ear-traveled trimaximalist, signing off.